Hey guys, it's Amy here with Gold Plating Services. I just wanted to show you this cool piece that we're doing for one of our customers. I believe it's called the Hellcat. We are going to put it in our chrome stripper prolab setup today, and then we will surface activate and then add some bright gold onto it. All right, so we have racked the emblem and it is in our new chrome stripping prolab tower. We are at about 4 volts and we are going to strip it for about 2 minutes. While that's going, I just wanted to give you guys a few reminders that with the chrome stripping, the chrome on different items will be plated at different thicknesses. 2 minutes is about a good place to start. After we go through the chrome stripper, we are going to go into our surface activator. We'll just go in there for probably about 15 to 30 seconds, and then we will go over into our bright gold tank. All right, so we just came out of our activator. We are going to go into our bright gold. And we're gonna plate it for probably about 5 minutes at about, let's turn our voltage down just a little bit. We don't want to burn the gold. All right. So we are getting to about 2 minutes. We've been doing some in-house plating of our prolab parts. We're gonna pull this out. This isn't good. All right, let's rinse this off and see what's going on. All right, so the part had been in there for about 2 minutes. Okay, if you can tell, the gold's not adhering. It looks like you can see some areas where the gold has gone on. Let's see what else we can find out. All right, so I've got Holden here kind of wiping it down. Okay, so this is great for you guys to know. As you come across different chrome plated items that are normally chrome plated, it doesn't necessarily mean that they're chrome plated. What you're seeing here where we can rub off that gold is a good indicator that this is actually fabricated out of aluminum, not chrome plated. So if you look at the rag that Holden is working on, that stuff is just coming right off. Another option that you can do is we're gonna take some tape, and there's some areas where that's on there. Let's see if it will come off. Sear tape. All right, so if you guys see that, the gold is coming right off on the tape. This is an aluminum item which cannot be done with any of our electroplating equipment. It is going to require that you send in the part to a company to have a nickel plate professionally put on. Once the nickel plate is put on, then you would be able to go through the electroclean surface activator and then the bright gold process. Keep in mind that when you do send in aluminum parts, you'll notice on the back of this item, there was some, what do you call it?
M3E sticky tape stuff.
Yeah, that's going to have to be removed before you send it in. So for those of you that might even fabricate or do these in your shop, it is good for you to know that not to put that on until after the plating process. Some of the chemicals can affect it, or the tape will affect our chemicals, and so it will have to be removed. So we just want to kind of do you guys a favor, help educate you guys a little bit more with what's out there. We don't want you to be frustrated. Another good resource at this point would be some
Mother's Max aluminum polish.
Yeah, and that will clean up all that gold that's on there to a point where you could send it in to be nickel plated. All right, hope this helps. Take care.